yet within time, speak, foreign nation. Under the warm glow of the moon, and as lamps were lit, she would sit quietly, listen to stories and tales that filled her imagination like magic gold. She would spend her days recounting these tales that grew more and more vivid with every passing moon, sharing them only with the beasts of the land and the birds of the sky, always by her side, under moon's great shadow. Was Ousha. The stories that danced in Ousha's soul knew no bounds. She gathered them, composed them, learn by heart. Ousha found herself in the deepest dream, a dream beyond all others, mysterious. A path of light called her name. Her friends, always by her side, willed her to follow without doubt or fear. Before her, of the earth and of the light, a creature of transcendent beauty beckons her towards something extraordinary. As the stars swirled and spun, and the clouds dissolved like dust, they climbed further and further into the night, into the light. Within the magic, the moment, the miraculous, echoing out across the moonlight's milky glow, a face appeal to Ousha. Neither stranger nor relative. A woman. A mirror. It was herself. Ousha. The woman. The poet she will become. A voice finally found.
At sunrise, I left my home. From land, I parted ways, looking forward to the north, and to the way I set my gaze. I stepped forward to the land,
where soul and soil do meet, in the loving arms of a wasl. Where my journey was complete.
A gust of wind from the direction of Dubai brought to my ears a whisper.
Thank you. Laureate.